We are all assembled here to wage a war against one of the crucial evils of modern society. This is not a newcomer. We have existed for the past several millennia. We have been relentlessly fought by innumerable people of various centuries. The existence of evil, battle between evil and virtues, success and re-entry of evil, rescheduling of the fight, all these four things are inescapable zones of global functioning. These things will continue to exist till the complete annihilation of the globe itself. So we are in this phase of transition of preventing the re-entry of evil and to fortify the society with its essential models which are indispensable for the harmonious functioning of the society. And whenever we are taking a single evil, it does not mean that there are no other evils. Each and every evil has its own brotherhood and can be with other things. And alcoholism, I want to say that it is a genocide. Just as in war, thousands of people are killed. Just as in deluge, dissolution and disaster, thousands of people are killed. It is also, alcoholism is also killing the people. It is not only killing the people. It is killing the valuable labor of people for contributing for the society, for the family. It is killing the precious time and putting them into intoxication, which deals with the lethargic nature, sleepiness, hyperventilation and various other things. It also kills the efficiency of people and integrity between the society and its members. It also reduces the lifespan of the people. And also, it aims at health hazards. So we should understand that alcoholism should be considered as a campaign against a silent or a small way of genocide that is happening to society, which is killing the labor, health, integrity, harmony, efficiency and lifespan. We should also understand that if we say alcoholism, it does not mean that it is alcoholism alone. There are three things I want to say about alcoholism. One is equivalence. Second is fragmentation. And the third thing is alternatives. What is equivalence? There are a lot of people who won't drink at all, but whose behavior either equals or excels even the drunkards. So it is a characteristic affinity of somebody's behavior, which is beyond any alcohol, because they are having that inbuilt provision of alcoholic secretion, which do not require any other external stimulus. So there are second thing is known as alternatives, which we call, like the drug addiction and various other mispractices and malpractices of the society. They are also equally having the present relation with alcoholism. Third thing is fragmentation. Even though some things are not so cruel as what we call alcoholism, they have fragmented efficacy to deal with what the alcoholic influence is. For example, I want to say apathy itself is the fragmental portion of what alcoholism is, but those things are excusable, those things are tolerable, those things are adjustable, minimizable. So we are taking into something which is intolerable, which is reaching the surmounting the parallel peak of intolerability and crucialism that we are just now taking into account. So alcoholism is a representative of everything that nullifies human rationale, human coordination to think and act with the sanity and sensibility of what is happening in society. So alcoholism does not deal with the source of intoxication. It deals with act of intoxication. It deals with the impact of intoxication, where we lose our balance of emotional standard, where we lose our intellect, where we lose our responsibility towards the society. So alcoholism is a totalitarian name out of which any other beverage that is entering there, it is only a portion of it. So being against alcoholism is not only against the beverage of alcoholism, but the impact of alcoholism which makes the person to lose their morale, to lose their responsibility, to lose their efficacy and principled way of living. So it is a totalitarian or common perception of what we call alcoholism number one. And to bring the same thing in the limited time, I have to just run fast and finish this thing with some few points which may be the source of information and inspiration for proceeding this holy journey or crusade in a very infallibly successful manner in the future. It has to be taken in most of the parts of India and it is also a global message we know that. Number one, whenever we come to the psychology of what we call intoxication or psychology of alcoholism, whether it is external or internal, we should understand there are two principal energies. One is the survival or supporting energy, second is the stimulating energy. They are known as stimulants. You know that human beings, they get food, water and respiration and they survive. Apart from that, there is some sort of stimulation. Stimulation comes from motivation, inspiration from people, care from parents and other relatives and good personalities, and also it is nourished by a person's inner zeal and commitment. This is the natural stimulant that exists between all of these people. Whenever there is absence of this stimuli, whenever there is a deficit, whenever there is non-compatibility or aversion that is there in the human mind due to configurative divide or disability, then human being goes for external stimuli apart from this factor. Whatever alcohol gives, that is given by, that is positively supplemented by maternal care, paternal care, scholarly advice, preceptorial guidance, all of these positive factors are giving you essential manifestations in the form of care, concern, love, affection and various other things. Whenever there is either non-availability of external resources or inner resources so that we can receive all of these things, then the human mind goes for seeking some other external stimulus. Unless this foundation is understood by the society, alcoholism cannot be fully controlled at all, it cannot be approved at all. Number one, entry stimuli. Entry means it is time oriented, it is temporary. Secondly, it is imprecise, it has no effect at all, but due to the extreme bit of frustration, we used to resolve something based on self-deception. We are not getting any benefit, but we assume that we get some benefit. We are getting adversity, but we feel that we are getting solace and comfort. So this type of pseudo-hallucination, that the hallucination itself is pseudo. Pseudo-hallucination means that is double and double the hallucination that we get due to self-deception. Then due to these various things, we go for certain fatal illegal agencies or even some of the good agencies are there. Fraternal agencies and fatal agencies used to say in psychology. Whenever you go for certain things, that is that you should understand human mind. Human mind is full of blanks. We have to fill up the blanks. When they are happy, they have to celebrate it. When they are in distress, there should be a solace and embrace. And whenever they are in need of doing some work, they should be having some instigation. Then all of these blanks are not well filled, they will be ill-filled naturally. They will be ill-filled naturally. So, a positive direction towards, number one, work, towards relations and love-making, towards commitment, towards intellectual exercises like research, towards prayer and service to the society. If they are not properly filled in the band, whenever they are in solitude, whenever they are in distress, whenever they are happy, it knows no reason. They are happy, they are sad, they are alone, they are with people. Everything has its own reason for alcoholism. Why you are drinking, I am alone. Why you are drinking, I am with my friends. Why you are drinking, I am happy. Why you are drinking, you are sad. So for all reasons, there is a false justification to go into alcoholism. So they should be filled with the well-filling agents instead of ill-filling agents. Unless this type of campaign is spiritually taken, educationally imparted, inherited from the parents, very difficult to conduct such campaigns in the wrong way. It is started in the proper. It is a small iteration what we want to do. And second thing is, this type of stimuli, apart from getting from relation, from God, from parents, from social ideal models, we should get that. As is not obtainable, we are resorting to the filthiest elements known as commodities. Certain commodities are as per shastras, they are totally prohibited, you should not take it. Second thing is state of the commodity, like grapes are there, the shastras say that it is permissible, but the state of a stale nature of intoxicants that are situated inside the grape in the form of wine, that is prohibited. That is state prohibition. Third is quantity prohibition. Somebody told me there is only a quantity problem, you can take a limited quantity. No, it is not permissible at all. Because the type of self-restraint to limit the quantity is not available to all people. There are four problems according to spiritual sciences. What is gradual lift? You start with a small quantity, gradually you will be getting into alcoholic development program and it will become big quantity. Second thing is company lift. If you join with the drunkard, it may be induced more circumstantial quality. If you are habitually a limited drunkard, then gradually when you are pressurized by circumstances, it may go more. Fourth thing is very dangerous, anuvartana. Anybody having limited drinking in this birth, according to transmigration theory of Hinduism, will continue.